first memory of Macleay College was arriving, and it was so strict, the discipline was so strict here at Macleay, that I'd spent 2 years at university. So you can pretty much enter the lecture at any time, and to come in and be locked out of the room because I was 5 minutes late, that sort of gave me a wake-up call that I would miss every class if I didn't arrive on time and have the discipline that was required here at Macleay. Well, apart from making very good friends who either work in the industry or don't, people that we spent a year with very intimately, the practical experience here at Macleay became essential. And like I said, I spent 2 years at university before I came to Macleay, and the experience was totally different. While there is a strong sort of theory base, the practice that we learnt here at Macleay sort of became the basis and foundation for my work in the field that I do. So they're the sort of memorable things, the practical experience, hands-on experience that I gained at Macleay, I didn't get at university, and it was certainly a great foot into the door into the workforce. Well, I'd spent a year doing work experience at SBS, and that was encouraged at Macleay. That was one of the things that I really gained from Macleay College, that we were pushed and told to go out and do work experience was part of the criteria of our course. So I'd already spent a year doing work experience at Dateline, actually. So I've sort of gone full circle. I went in and did a week's work experience at Dateline, then ended up staying for a year. And on my days off from Macleay or in between classes, I'd go to Dateline and do research and translation. So I ended up, I've now presenting the show. So after sort of 7 years, I've come full circle. I spent a year doing, I suppose it was the work ethic that we gained from Macleay, that, take anything you can get. And the first year I spent doing night shifts from 10 o'clock at night till 6 o'clock in the morning, and then going off and getting a cadetship at SBS. So I basically worked my way up through the organisation. So it wasn't very new to me going into SBS. Persistence and hard work and perseverance are sort of the basis of what I do, and when I travel I get a lot of knockbacks and people who don't want to talk on camera or fear being interviewed, and so I suppose it's being able to nurture them and guide them through the stories that I want to do. I tell a lot of human interest stories for Dateline. I like to tell the human stories, so I suppose patience and perseverance are two things that I've gained from my career so far. I suppose don't rush into anything. I felt like I had to go down, finish school, get into university, get a good mark to go to the university of my choice and do the course that I wanted to do, or else life would be over. But there is life after the HSC, and there is a variety of courses you can do other than a straight university degree. You don't have to, follow the path of finishing school, going to university, getting a job. Find out what you love to do. And I wake up every morning and I love going to work. I love what I do, and I suppose that's what I would tell my 18-year-old self: stop freaking out, stop stressing, good things will come if you work hard.